Welcome back, everyone, to theCUBE's live coverage here in Orlando, Florida for Qlik Connect 2025. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. Bob Laliberte is here. Kristen Nicole Martin out doing a roving report, getting all the action, all the data, and all the insights. Of course, all the actions happening on theCUBE and here on the show floor. Of course, the keynote kicked off today. Got a great Women in Data panel. Miranda Foster, VP of Communications at Qlik. Steph Robinson, BI Manager for Qlik Platforms at JBS. Welcome back. It's Sadie St. Lawrence, founder and CEO of HMCI, also the founder of Women in Data. Great to see you. Thanks for coming on.
Happy to be here.
So, first question is, there's a panel coming up this afternoon, 5 to 6. I want to get into that, but the Women in Data movement is key, and stories power movements. Give us an update, Steph, on what's going on, the motivation, the vibe. What's the current state of Women in Data?
Sure, so if you look at Women in Data, you find that you have a lot of young girls and women who, when they're in school, they love data, they're good at mathematics, but when they actually start to graduate, they don't go into like STEM or IT. And this is one of the things we found. I think there's like 24% of girls out of school are going into like IT type careers to study. And of that, there's less than 15% actually kind of move up and then end up in like management positions. And we kind of started Women Who Qlik as the luminary group. So it was myself, it was Gwen and Priscilla. And we were in Lund this one day in one of our meetings. And we noticed there was three women and like about 30 men in the room. And it was nothing to do with, oh, wow, there's so many men. It was just, why so few women? And then we kind of came up with this, we need to do something about it, and it's become now quite a movement. Yeah. So it's become very grassroots with a lot of sponsorship from Qlik, and yet we have thousands of women now reaching out to us from all walks of life, really interested into how do they get more empowered and have a voice in the industry.
Share a story that illustrates that, because I think data is not like a computer science thing, or IT thing. Data is data.
Right.
I mean, data is, opens the aperture for all kinds of different skills in business, tech. I mean, it's huge.
Exactly.
Give a story of where these empowerment, this impact around women in data.
Well, one really interesting story, and I'm not going to name a name, but there was one girl who reached out to me on LinkedIn and had no IT background whatsoever. And not even a Qlik person, just kind of like heard about it and reached out. And I started talking to her. So she said, well, how do I learn IT? Like, she can't really go to college, she's got children, it's not kind of easy for her. So I said, start to learn Qlik. So she actually now has moved from learning Qlik to learning how to code in Qlik to working in a company that has Qlik, and now she's gotten herself into an IT field. And that's the power of just giving a voice and giving kind of a space where people can kind of realize, like, you don't have to be computer science trained or anything. You can make that happen.
And what's interesting, Steph, is that here at Qlik, one of the things that I'm really proud of is to be a part of an all-female marketing leadership team.
Amazing.
So, under Chris Powell, our chief marketing officer, he has an all-female leadership team. So even this conference is a great example of women coming together to put on amazing things.
Right.
And we couldn't do it without each other. So
yes,
it's like a cross-collaboration. And I think that's really a good example of a group of women who have come together to build something fantastic, and we all work together.
Yes, that's amazing. I love that.
Yeah,
I so love that.
I do too.
Yeah.
Talk about the community, Sadie, about this is the Women in Data. It's a community building network that's growing. Talk about some successes you've had, examples, kind of where is the community forming? Is it horizontal? Is it narrow? I mean, talk about the community.
Yeah, so the broader Women Data community is about 70,000 strong, and we partner with Qlik on a lot of initiatives. They actually sponsored for Ada Lovelace Day last year 10 scholarships that provided mentorship, learning pathways in data engineering, data science, data analytics. As you mentioned, it's different than just computer science. You can pretty much put data in front of any word now, and it's a new job that's forming and evolving. So what's happening that we're seeing is not only are people coming in for new career changes that are happening, but there's new pathways being evolved, right? So we first started with data analytics and data engineering, and now expanding into a lot of the AI work that's happening as well. And we heard that today with some of the announcements in the keynotes. It was really excited to see Qlik Answers. Last week, I actually built a RAG model with Qlik Answers, and so excited to see what more things we can do, and how data really is now evolving into the AI world, and what careers it enables for women, I think, is really the story that we want to share.
Miranda, we use the word democratization over and over again. Now with AI, the answers meets the analytical cloud that Qlik has. You essentially, if you know how to ask the question, you're going to get an answer. Okay, so, okay, zoom out. The human in the loop isn't a man in the loop or a woman in the loop, it's a human, right? So human in the loop drives all the performance. That's the theme we heard from Adam on the cycling team that you guys sponsor. The data supports everything, so you got a new phenomenon. It's not new to the world, but humans are driving it. Right. So that's everybody. This is a huge advantage.
Well, Sadie talked about new pathways, and I was actually going to chime in and say with the explosion of AI, it's going to open so many new doors, not just for women, but you know, young women, women out of college. You talked a little bit about that. And one of the things that Ritu said on stage today, because I think Mike asked her directly, you know, are people going to lose their jobs? No, it's quite the opposite. Yeah. It's going to create new opportunities and new pathways and new opportunities for these young women, women like the woman who reached out to you on LinkedIn, to come in and potentially have new career opportunities. So I think it's actually a wonderful evolution and will open a lot of doors.
Right. I think it's really important too. So I think one of the things that's vital is to let women know that they can go into these fields.
Yeah.
Right? Because they do tend to be male dominated. I don't know why, they just do tend to be male dominated.
Yeah.
And I think women tend to feel like they can't speak or reach into these areas. And I don't have any statistics as to why that is, but I do. One of the things I do know that's very, very, very strongly is that mentorship, whether it's a mentorship from a man or a woman, around women, really can help bring them up. So one of the things that we also do with Women Who Qlik is really promote mentorship to kind of help bring people into these fields and like change those statistics that I was talking about.
Yeah, mentorship, also sponsoring. And identifying value, that because the theme here at Qlik Connect is unlocking the value of the data, right?
Yes.
So when you look at like the old school, just some trends we're covering on SiliconANGLE and theCUBE is that the world was databases, SQL queries. So those are nerdy tech things. Now that's being abstracted away to business logic, okay, which is not even a, there's no discussion of like queries. They're just, hey, I want an answer. You can voice prompt it. So prompting, the AI wave is huge change. How do you guys see the Gen AI impact? Because are there strategies for people to learn? How do people approach this? How do other women share their stories? Because now with AI, it's a level setter. You don't have to go to some Ivy League school or have a pedigree or whatever. You can come in and level up.
Right. And I think that's one of the things about Qlik. So I got into IT because of Qlik. So I had an art background actually, not a data background. But it was because of Qlik that I learned how to code, and I learned everything and ended up into an IT field. And I think now with AI and with everything that's coming out and what the future holds, I think that's going to be personified probably 1,000 times.
Yeah.
Because there's so much opportunity, and it's about women reaching out for that opportunity.
You know what I find, Miranda? We talked about sports last night. I know you're a huge sports fan. And Qlik, by the way, is huge sports culture in the DNA, which I love. But sports and music seem to be two themes, art, sports. So craft and like, not nerdy stuff, although there's a lot of great nerd action going on with all the tech, but when you start getting into solutions, it's teamwork, it's creativity, it's performance, like sports or art or music. Like the keynote had one person playing a guitar, but other people playing with him. So doing it differently is the theme here. That's a game changer. So how do people get to a comfort level, women, other women, to say, okay, I can dominate? Is there strategies that you guys see? Are there workflows?
Yeah, I mean, I think, like you mentioned, AI is a great democratizer because it allows more pathways for people to come in. You know, with the tools are there, the education, the mentorship is there, the support. what really we want is people bringing their diverse backgrounds in, right? So if you have a background in music, you're going to have a different perspective, a background in sports. If you're coming from a marketing background and want to add in new AI skills or add in generative AI skills to imagine things differently. So I think the main message is take whatever your background is, don't throw that out because that's useful, and just add on these new skills, add on learning a new tool like Qlik. I mean, I was so impressed last week with Qlik Answers and what I was able to build in literally a matter of minutes. And you know, 10 years ago I got into this space and I remember learning R and having to like take forever learning to code. And I'm like, this is such a game changer. I wish I was starting over now because it would have been so much easier. So if anything, I just encourage more people to explore this area and bring in their diverse background, whatever that may be, because we need that unique perspective to create new solutions.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
And don't be afraid to ask for help. Yeah. Don't be afraid to tap a colleague on the shoulder and say, hey, can I get some advice? Or would you like to be my mentor? Because I mentor a lot of the a lot of women in our company, and I've had the great fortune of being mentored. And I just think that is so important because, like you said, we all have such a diverse skill set. We can certainly learn from each other.
Yes, absolutely.
So you guys got a lot going on. There's a big event here in the venue. If you're watching on site, if you're not here, then you can go figure out what's going on later, probably online, maybe a blog post. What's happening? What's this event? It's 5 to 6, Women Who Qlik is a session.
Yes.
So what's the agenda?
I think it's five of us on stage. And it will really be just a discussion around women in tech and women in data. And just really kind of like all the different challenges. What is a different challenge that a woman has? Like, you know, a mom with a 2-year-old and a newborn and having to like juggle being on an IT help desk, you know, like how do you kind of work with that? I gave that example because that's my daughter, right? but you know, there's challenges there, right? So, you know, kind of how do women move into tech? How do women move into data? How do they juggle all the challenges of being a woman, which is different to being a man? And wonderful, right? So we're going to have a lot of discussion around that, a lot of different stories, how we all kind of ended up where we came, how Women Who Qlik came about, what the future's going to hold for Women Who Qlik, and you know, kind of, and women in data, and where that's going to go, and how we can just empower more women and inform more men to help mentor more women. So it's going to be very encompassing and very fun. And there will be a happy hour. So
okay, of course, that's always the best part. How do people get involved in the community? Is there any kind of coordinates you can share? You got some great stuff going on. Say, Miranda, what do you got going on?
So for Women in Qlik, within in the on the Qlik website, there is a Women Who Qlik page. And then we'll be sending more out about that. We do a lot of LinkedIn Lives. We were on data, I forgot the last name of it, on LinkedIn. So we do a lot of different stuff. But and then we always are inviting other women to come in and speak. Yeah. But we're going to be looking at doing some women training, you know, getting people in to do some of the exams, the Qlik exams. We've got a whole bunch of ideas coming up. So we'll talk about some of those tonight.
Yeah, you guys. We have really cool swag.
And I'd encourage everybody, womenindata.org, we have 55 chapters in 70 countries.
That's amazing.
So there's somewhere that you can connect with pretty close to you. And if it's not close to you, you're welcome to start a new chapter. Yeah. So always welcome to bring more people into the community that way.
Yeah, really appreciate that. What a great community you have there. Congratulations. Yeah, final lightning round ending question is, breakthroughs are all about AI, humans making breakthroughs with data. Share a breakthrough story that you, each of you might have had over the past year that came from data. It doesn't have to be Qlik, it could be Qlik, it could be whatever. A breakthrough that you, what happened that was compelling.
Oh, a breakthrough in data?
Could be anything, could be a better commute home to, or some innovation, some breakthrough that you leverage data with that either surprised you or made the company successful or anything.
So at HMCI, we did a study on how AI could be used at work. And what we did was we took job descriptions, pulled out every task from a job description, and then paired that with data on AI use cases. And it was really insightful because what we found was that AI cannot do your full job, just as we talk about, but we have data to back it. But what it could do, it could help with about 35% of tasks. And we were able to pinpoint down where I could use AI really specifically for what task in my life and for the rest of our team, which was fantastic. So That's okay. My favorite AI use case.
And mine is similar. So I run communications for the company. So obviously I do a lot of writing. I do a lot of writing on behalf of our executives. And it's fascinating to me. First of all, the AI tool gets smarter as the more you use it. And it will get you 80% of the way there. So my efficiency, my productivity has increased astronomically because if I'm writing, let's just say an email to the board or an email on behalf of the CEO or something like that, I can talk to my AI tool and it will, you know, write whatever I tell it to write. And you have to humanize it, and that's where the human factor comes into it. But my efficiency and productivity has increased significantly. My boss calls ChatGPT our junior copywriter.
I love that.
It's a great assistant,
too. It's a great assistant.
It gives you feedback. Too much jargon. Yeah. Okay, way too much jargon.
So I did think of one, which is actually really interesting. So we, at JBS, so we have a lot of developers. We have about 140 people developing in the Qlik space. And we have a chat. And so people were on this chat, and it goes 24/7. Like people say, hey, can you help me with this? Or, you know, it's a lot of collaboration, right? So we are using a chatbot to kind of look at all the things that are being talked about, and then pick out the key things that people are having trouble with. And so then we are about to start doing specific training on the reoccurring questions. So this there's a lot more to come on that, but it's actually quite exciting, and it's really it's helping take my team from having to answer everything as well, so it's going to be very good.
There's a lot of these little breakthroughs that lead to other things. What's great about the data world right now, it's such a great environment. Thank you so much for sharing, and good luck with your panel.
Thank
Five
you.
To six and happy hour, of course. Yes. We'll do a flyby.
Yeah, it's
Thanks
be
for
fun.
Coming on.
Thanks
okay,
for having
I'm
us.
John, for bringing all the data here on theCUBE. I'm John, your host of theCUBE. We'll be right back after this short break.